Greetings, Jesus of the world. What a marvelous time, what a marvelous hour. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord make his face shine upon your life. My name is Yamkela Joseph, and I believe that God is about to do something bigger, something greater in your life. The Bible says that in that latter hour, in that latter day, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. God has promised that in this hour, we will not be believers by reading just the Bible, but we will be believers because of the Spirit of the living God that is within us. Today I want to talk to you about something very important, which I have titled Spiritual Warfare, a life of war in Jesus Christ. Many people don't understand that by being born again, not only have you joined the kingdom of God, but you have also joined the army of Jesus Christ against the most vile, the most dangerous, the most vile kind of armies of darkness. The enemy has no mercy. The devil, the Bible says he is like a roaring lion looking whom to devour. Satan is on a spree, making sure that he wants to terminate everything that looks like Jesus, everything that is looking like a believer in the planet Earth. The enemy is fighting. So the day that you accepted Jesus Christ, it was the day you asked God to make you part of the war that is happening between the kingdom of light and the kingdom of darkness. So many believers today, they live as if they are just on a social club, as if like they have just joined this pedest beauty pageant kind of an environment. No, Christianity is not that kind. It is a warfare. It is a realm of war. We are dealing with vile spirits. We are dealing with merciless demons, unconscientized spirits, spirits that do not care, spirits who have no fear of the Lord, unrepentant powers of darkness. Those are kind of demons and powers of and principalities that we are dealing with. So today I want to talk to you about a message that I've tackled, the life of warfare, because I understand that many of us today are fighting battles and some are sleeping. They don't understand the kind of enemy that we are fighting. I want you to go with me in the book of Ephesians right now, in Ephesians number 6, in Ephesians number 6, and hear what the Bible says. Ephesians number 6, verse number 10. The Bible says, finally, be strengthened by the Lord and by his vast strength. Put in the full armor of God, so that you can stand against the schemes of the devil. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers of darkness, against evil spiritual forces in heavens. For this reason, take up the full armor of God, so that you may be able to resist in the day of evil. Having prepared everything to take your stand, stand therefore with the truth like a belt around your waist, righteousness like an armor on your chest, and your feet sandaled with the readiness for the gospel of peace. In every situation, take up the shield of faith, which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Pray all times in the Spirit with every prayer and request, and stay alert with all perseverance and intercession for all saints. Pray for me that the message may be given to me when I open up my mouth to make known with boldness the mystery of the gospel. For this I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I might be bold enough to speak about it as I should. Now the Apostle Paul is writing from a prison, telling the believers in the church of Ephesus that this warfare is not against our neighbors, our friends. It's against principalities and powers, rulers of darkness, unseen spirits that are within the cosmic areas and powers. The Bible says we are fighting against principalities and powers in the realm of the spirit. You as a Christian today, You are not living a physical life. You are living a life of the spirit, a life where a lot of demons, a lot of spirits and powers are prepared by the enemy to come against you. You are a spiritual workforce. You are called by God to become a resisting power against the kingdom of darkness. Now the Apostle Paul said, brothers and sisters, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Take out the armor of the Lord so that you may stand in the day of evil. He said, so that you may be able to devise the schemes of darkness. Family, I want to say to you, the enemy is not sleeping day and night. The devil is planning how to attack, how to extinguish, how to destroy the children of God. Each and every day of your life, Satan is planning against you. Satan is making sure that each and every day he is devising strategies, ways and devices of how to overthrow your faith, how to throw you down as a child of the Lord. If you are sleeping in this hour, you are going to become a victim of the enemy. The Apostle Paul, when he speaks about this, he says, for we are not ignorant of the devil's devices, so that he may not take advantage of us. I want you to understand that you are on a war. You did not join a social club. You did not join a place where everything is just gonna be well. You know, sometimes in the prophetic, we speak about you having a breakthrough, wealth and every other thing, until you begin to think that it's about enjoyment in this world. No, it's not about enjoyment. We are on a serious warfare. We are on a serious battle between the kingdom of light and the kingdom of darkness. The enemy is fighting for territory. The enemy is fighting for souls. The enemy is making sure that no soul is saved. No believer wins. No believer makes it. No believer is able to destroy the kingdom of darkness. Remember, the Bible says, for the Son of Man was made to manifest that he may destroy all the works of the evil one. The devil understands that the day we accepted Jesus Christ, that's the day we pledge our allegiance with Christ. That's the day we decided to become ambassadors of the gospel and destroyers of the kingdom of darkness. So from that day, Satan is fighting. From that day, the enemy is fighting, because he understands that you are now an ambassador. You are now an agent. You are now a secret intelligence of heaven, and you are on a mission of destroying his kingdom. When we go up and preach the gospel and win souls, we are on a spiritual warfare. There are resisting spirits. There are demons. There are powers of darkness that are making so that our message, that our life does not prosper. Nothing works in this gospel, because the gospel, it is a force. A gospel, it is a saving mission. The Apostle Paul said, I'm not afraid to preach the gospel, for it is the power of God unto salvation of men. Right now, I want you to understand, you have been called into a life of warfare. Christianity is not just a religion, but it is a military. It is a place where the enemy has waged a war, and we have declared a war against the kingdom of darkness. But I want to say to you, we are born to win. We are born to be overcomers. We are born to be more than conquerors through him that gave birth to us. Jesus has made sure that in the cross he disarmed the enemy. He disarmed the powers of darkness, so that me and you may walk in a victorious life. We have won against the enemy. We have won against the children of darkness. We are the children of light. And you ought to understand that our warfare is not against Britain. It's not against flesh and blood, but it's against principalities and powers. I want to pray with you right now. The Spirit of the Living God is an intelligent spirit. It is a spirit that has given us strength and power, so we may be able to counteract the devices of darkness, so we may be able to counteract every plan of Satan against our lives, against our ministry, against what God has called us to do on the planet Earth. Remember, each and every day the devil is not sleeping. He's trying to make sure that you do not prosper, that you do not attain what God has called you to attain, that you do not fulfill the purpose of the Lord for your life. Satan is fighting. Demons are strategically working right now as we are talking, working against you, planning meetings, strategic planning against you. But I want you to understand that we have been given victory. We are victorious in Jesus Christ. I want to pray for you to have strength. I want to pray for you to take out the armor of the Lord, the helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the waist of the truth, and the shield of faith, which is we are able to shield every fiery dart of the enemy. Right now, I pray for you that you may receive the strength of the Lord. So I want you to stretch your hands right now towards me as I pray. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for my friend right now as where they are. I declare that the enemy will not win every battle against their life. I declare they will prosper in whatsoever purpose you have sent them to achieve in this planet earth. Father, I pray right now by the blood of Jesus that Satan has been defeated in their lives. Satan has been defeated in everything that they are doing. And I decree that they will serve the purpose of the Lord and they will not lose in the blood of Jesus. Father, I rebuke every cankerworm and every caterpillar. I break every agent of darkness. I expose every agent of Satan that is after their life. I declare, Satan, the blood of Jesus is against you. He is defeated. He is broken down in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you in the name of Jesus, and we declare we have won in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Family, I want to say to you right now, you have won every battle, and Jesus Christ is on your side. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. Continue to watch Jesus Reigns TV. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you share. My name is Yankee Jones.